Rob, you've been going well, but I should think that the conversation we had earlier on, you're not quite as happy as you should be.
Well, I think we did leave a few points in Le Ball in Rome through different circumstances, which always happens in Nations Cups. I think there's seven very, very strong teams here, and obviously there's eight in total, but Denmark are obviously struggling a little bit because they're inexperienced. The other seven teams are very strong, and I can see a real battle ahead with the seven teams that are in there.
You know, France and Germany, for example, they're going even worse than you, and you'd have to say on paper they were very strong in the first two legs.
Yeah, we actually all had very strong teams out. That's the worrying thing, really. I mean, France certainly had their strongest team out. Germany was pretty very strong in Rome. I mean, we had a strong team. We have one or two horses coming back, which we planned for a bit later on in the season. But it's a tough competition.
How does it work, you know, with horses? It affects some horses worse than others, having to jump two rounds over the same course. Like, for example, when I walked the course in La Ball, I thought it was a fairly reasonable course, as a lot of other people did. It was a different ball game in the second round, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think those early ones, fitness comes into it a lot. A lot of horses obviously starting off in Le Ball, or more or less start off in Le Ball, and then two rounds does make a huge difference. And I think jumping two rounds, jumping the water jump in particular twice, I think in Rome, you know, there was 30 horses in the water jump.
It could be a tough call here this afternoon, because this ground is always a bit tacky, isn't it? A bit heavy, and they've had some rain again.
They've had some rain, and it feels very, very good, but as you say, you know, it does hold a little bit, and over two rounds it can be quite long, and normally it's a very big course here in St Gallen. I'm hoping for the best.
Yes, I mean, you know, people tend to think of Aachen and Rome as being the pinnacle of this series, but this always takes a lot of winning here, doesn't it?
This was one of the toughest ones last year, for sure. And, you know, we're hoping to do well. We've got a mixture of experience and slightly younger horses, so it'll be very interesting what we come up with here.
Who have you got here today? I know you've got Nick and Robert as your mainstays, but and Tim.
Yeah, I've got Nick and Robert and Tim, and then I've got Scott Bresch and Ben Mayer. I mean, Ben, obviously, although he's young, he's very experienced, but he's on a relatively young horse, 9-year-old. Jumped in Rome very, very well in the second round, and a little bit green in the first round. And I've got to make a choice still, who's going to be my four.
Yeah, Robert had a little bit of a hiccup in the Grand Prix, didn't he, in Rome?
Yeah, it's funny, something happens in the second round of the Nations Cup. He jumped a fantastic first round, and we're not sure whether the horse may be tied up very slightly or something happened, and in the second round it just wasn't the same horse, and a similar thing in the Grand Prix. But he looks fine now. We're going to see how he jumps tonight and then make a decision after that.
Yeah, there's a decent class tonight, so you'll have a run round with most people and then make a decision.
Yeah, both Ben and Robert are going tonight because I wanted to see the horses in the bigger class to make a proper judgment on the horses on how they're going, and then it'll probably be a pick between those two for the fourth place.
Nick and Tim would be bankers, obviously.
Nick definitely. Tim also, his horse already jumped. I think Scott's also in, and then we're going to look at Ben and Robert tonight.
Tough decisions.
Yeah, that's what you pay me for.
Well done. Thanks a lot. Good luck.
Okay, thanks.